everybody. This is Fitness Leader Sporsky again on behalf of Skynetics, and today I'm excited to share with you our first Sky High Challenge. Now, some of you may be wondering what the Sky High Challenge is. Here at Skynetics, our philosophy is progression, achievement, success. We like to set SMART goals for our viewers so that we can enable them to help progress their fitness game. SMART goals is an acronym which stands for specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and timely. Here at Skynetics, we believe strongly in goal setting theory. Some of the reasons it's important to set goals are: goals can give you a target to aim for, goals can help you concentrate your time and effort, goals can provide motivation, persistence, and desire, goals can help you establish priorities. We believe goal setting is equivalent to a roadmap, which will take you from where you are to where you want to be. So now that we've gone ahead and worked on our Bosu Ball routine, we want to progress from there by standing on a Bosu Ball with one foot. Like standing on a Bosu Ball, you want to put the cushiony side down towards the ground and place the foot that you're going to be balancing on in the middle center line of the Bosu Ball. Like so. Now, this is a fairly challenging workout, so I hope that you've been practicing your Bosu Ball balance. Progressing from the Bosu Ball balance routine, we want to then lift the leg that we are going to be not using off of the ground, like so. Now, for beginners, I suggest that possibly just balancing with one foot is ideal, but because we want this to be a challenge and we hope that you've been practicing your Bosu Ball balance, to challenge yourself, we want you to raise your knee at a 90 degree angle, like so, and then raise your arms towards the sky. Balancing on a Bosu Ball with one foot, the initial beginner step. Side view. Coming up off of the ball, raising your knee to a 90 degree angle. Now, this might be an intermediate. If you're not comfortable with raising your knee that high, it's sufficient to just stand on a ball with your leg fairly close to the ground. Practicing on this balance will help you progress to raising your knee to the 90 degree angle. So now I'm going to perform different exercises standing on the Bosu Ball with one foot. Again, raising my knee to the 90 degree angle and lengthening my core and reaching for the sky. The step is to extend your leg out while balancing on the Bosu Ball. And remember to keep the Bosu Ball centered without swaying to either side or fixing it to either side. Typically, I like to hold this position and do 10 kickouts, frontal kickouts, and then extending my leg and slowly bringing it across the transverse plane to a yoga position at my side. So after you complete 10 frontal kicks, we then want to move to the side kicks, which is really going to concentrate on your hip flexors and going to give you that deep transversus cut. So now, like bringing my foot out to the 90 degree position in the front, I want to bring it to the side. And then raise my arms, making sure that the Bosu Ball isn't fixed on one side, you want it on the center line. And then like the frontal kicks, you want to do the side kicks. Another great routine to practice is by doing a front kick and holding that position while slowly moving it to the side, like so. and then holding that position. And then bringing it back. And forth. And then comes the one-legged squat thrust, which is one of my favorites because it works out your leg and also your core stability, and it's similar to a leg in for abdominal workout. So here we're going to perform the one-legged squat thrust. Copyright pending. Raising your leg to the 90 degrees. Lengthening your core, bringing your leg behind you slightly while keeping your balance and squatting down on your planted foot. Holding this position, lengthening your core, you're really going to feel this in your gluteus maximus, your quadriceps, your hamstrings, your legs, transverse abdominis, your gluteus medius. And then after holding it for 3 to 5 seconds, thrust your leg up. Thrust your leg up. Hold 3 to 5 seconds. Your extended leg, you want to lock and squeeze your gluteus maximus, keeping the Bosu ball on the center line. Thrusting your leg up. Holding the position. Now I bring my arms down with me because it helps my balance. Other viewers will have different preferences as far as what they do with their arms. So 3 to 5 seconds. Thrust your leg up. So now I'm going to perform all three workouts without a rest, and hopefully viewers like you will be able to attain this level at some point as well. Standing on the Bosu ball at the 90 degree with my right knee. Kick out. Thrust. Now to add extreme difficulty, go over the past Bosu ball workouts and flip the Bosu ball onto the hard part of the surface. I myself am working on this because it's a challenge for me, but I hope that even if you can do it, you can respond with a video and show me different types of workouts that you're able to do on the Bosu ball. So I hope everybody enjoys the Bosu ball challenge. One of the reasons that I love it so much is because remember that your legs are half of your body. If you're looking to lose weight, tone up, or even gain power, a lot of your calorie burning will come from working on your legs. So doing the squats for guys and girls is an excellent way to gain your goals. So remember to go and practice, and hopefully you're able to attain the Bosu ball challenge. I really look forward to future videos, and I hope that you guys also respond with comments and maybe even suggestions as far as workouts go. So an exciting moment for Skynetics. Our website is up and you can go and view it at www.skynetics.ca. Thank you so much for watching our Bozu Ball Challenge. I hope that it challenges you enough to want to practice the Bozu Ball routine and hopefully progress your fitness game with Skynetics. Thank you so much. It's out of the way.